Hey, check it out. We're going to be looking at our first P55 board today from ASUS, the P7P55 D Pro. Good stuff. Stay tuned. Check it out in a second. All right, so here she is, the first P55 board I get my hands on. We have an all-new architecture. We got some new chips. We got the Core i5s and the new Core i7s for the socket 1156. And this would be the first Pro board from ASUS. Now, ASUS, when they do the D over here, that's the high-end board. And then the Pro means it's professional, so it's not going to have a lot of extras on it. It's not going to have overclocking stuff. But it does overclock, and it's got great hardware for overclocking as well. It just doesn't have like the little push start buttons and all this extra stuff that you're not really going to use if you're going to use it in a professional sense, as in a workstation for editing or as in a professional computer that just needs to be fast. Now, let's talk about this board. First of all, you are going to notice that it is a new socket. Again, we are now working with the socket 1156. This is going to take all your Linfield processors from Intel, so your Core i5s and your Core i7s on that 1156 socket. We also have a new memory configuration here. You'll notice that there's not triple channel like there was on X58. There's only dual channel, and that makes things a little bit more affordable for people moving on from a, let's say, X48 or X38 based DDR3 system. You don't have to buy extra memory. It's going to pop in here. You just got to run it at the lower voltage, which the board will do automatically. So that's really good. You'll also know that there's no more North Bridge, and that's because it's a whole new architecture for P55. You pretty much have the P55 down here, and it's called the PCH, Platform Controller Hub. Basically, that takes care of all the USBs, all the SATA, all that good stuff. PCI Express goes directly to the CPU. Memory goes directly to the CPU. There is no QPI. It's a DMI, direct media interface, and pretty much you bring it down to two chips on the board. That makes things cheaper, more affordable, and that makes sure that everything else on the board is even that much better. Now, let's talk a little bit about PCI Express. We have a lot of connectivity on this board. As you can see, there are three PCI Express X16 2.0 slots over here, and the way these work, you actually get 16 lanes coming from a P55 board or an i5 CPU. The way it works is X16, so when you split these down to two and you run either CrossFire or SLI, which the board is certified for both, you're going to get X8 and X8. If you were to further bifurcate that down, you'd get X8, X4, X4, which wouldn't be your greatest idea for triple SLI, but it will work. It will also work for triple CrossFireX or whatnot. You also have two standard PCI slots, and you have two PCI Express X1 2.0 slots as well, so that's a lot of connectivity you have there. You also have a lot of SATA ports on here. Looking over here on this side, we actually have four SATA ports right here, and we have an additional two right there on that part of the board. So that's six in total, and these are all connected to the Intel Matrix Manager technology. So basically, these are going to give you RAID 0, RAID 1, 0 plus 1, 1 plus 0, and RAID 5 through here. You also have an additional SATA port right there. That one's going to go to a separate controller. I believe it's either a Marvell or a J-Micron. Those are the ones that control this extra SATA port and the eSATA that's also on the back panel, so it's important to have. Now, speaking of the back panel, let's go on a brief tour, show you what you got over here. A couple PS2s for your keyboard and mouse. Those are on professional boards, just in case you're using older keyboard and mouse. They are going to be there. You have a bunch of USB 2.0s. You got 2, 4, 6, and then 8 on the back panel alone. You have another 6 on the inside via header. You have SPDIF in both coaxial and optical. You have FireWire, you have eSATA, you have 10100, 1000 gigabit Ethernet right there, and you have 7.1 channel HD audio with a really nice controller, really nice signal to noise ratio, so it actually works very well. You may not even ever really want to get an external sound card because it sounds so good with the built-in controller. Now, there's features on these ASUS boards, as always, not as much as, let's say, a deluxe or a premium model, but the pros are definitely a step up from the bottom, and you do see it in this board. First of all, the layout is great. It looks really nice. Great choice of colors. You also get a lot of great overclocking tools. You get Japanese-made solid caps, so those are not going to pop on you. You have great hardware. This board actually has 12 plus 2 phases of power, so you have 12 phases for the CPU, as you can see over here, and you have an additional 2 just for the memory alone, so that's going to be great for overclocking. You also have a lot of FireWire connectivity on the board. You actually have headers. You have 2 headers down here, so that's an additional 2 FireWires you can add on. You have a bunch of extra USB 2.0s for extra connectivity there. You also have the IDE interface if for any reason you're still using an old IDE drive, you just want to plug in an old drive to get something off of it, that connectivity is still there as well, which is really good. Now, the board doesn't come with power, reset, and clear CMOS buttons, again, because it's just a Pro. It's not the Premier or the Deluxe, but a lot of people don't need that and also don't want it. You don't want to pay extra for it. You want to get extra money in your GPU and your graphics or in your case and your power supply or get the fastest chip available at the time. You want to go i7 over i5. Whatever the case may be, the board brings a lot to the table for the money. It also has its very niche market of people that want to have the high-end performance on the CPU, the memory, and the GPU, but they don't want to spend extra money for features they're not going to use. Now, another interesting feature on here, let's take a look right over here. This is the Memo K button. That's interesting because ASUS has always been known for their certified vendors for memory, and a lot of chips don't work, a lot of DIMMs don't work. This chip pretty much is going to reboot your computer, and it's going to run a little program. It's going to try to figure out what's going on with the memory and in turn make it compatible. So you can now use any memory that you want on these boards. Speaking of memory, another cool little item. If you see right here, these DIMMs, they only have clips on one side, so you don't have to take out your video card to take out the memory chips anymore. That's genius. You pretty much slide it into one side, and it's a one-touch push to get a DIMM in there. That's really nice. On top of that, you also have the Turbo V chip. So that's a high-end feature on this board. Turbo V is the hardware chip on these motherboards from ASUS now that lets you do hardware overclocking inside the operating system, and it's not limited to just your base clock and a few other things. It actually gives you a whole host of voltages, frequencies, and settings that you can adjust, as well as adjusting your memory. So that's very powerful as well. Also, of course, it is a ASUS board, so you will have ExpressGate, which is an instant on or nearly instant on OS. It takes about 5 seconds to boot into it. It's a little mini Linux distro. You can get your email, Skype, you can do VoIP calls, you can chat on the web, you can look at a picture, and it does all that without turning on the rest of the computer to waste power. You know, it's basically just running off an embedded chip. The other thing that you have to save power is the EPU system. Automatically throttles your CPU and your memory down when you're not using the computer to save as much power as possible, and that's pretty good stuff for a board that's not really meant for an enthusiast. It's meant for a high-end regular consumer. Those are a lot of really good features, even features such as T-Probe, which is something that you've only seen on the high-end boards. The newest high-end boards, T-Probe is actually a hardware that monitors how much it monitors the thermal loads and the balances in between all the VRM circuitry. So sometimes, even though you have 12 phases of power, only like two will get really hot because they're doing all the work. T-Probe is actually going to check those thermals. It's going to measure the temperatures, and it's going to spread it out more naturally. That in turn is going to give you cleaner power, give you a better overclock, or just a generally more stable system. So really, really nice stuff from this first P55 board that I got to get my hands on. It's the P7P55D from ASUS, and if you have any questions, as always, feel free to email me right here, and I'll see you guys next time. For more information on the ASUS P7P55D Pro Intel Socket 1156 motherboard, type in A455-2913 into the search engine of any of these major retailers. For Computer TV, this is Albert. We'll be right back.